In this video, we're going to take a closer look at standing waves. A standing wave is created when a wave interferes with itself after reflecting off a surface. The places where destructive interference occurs are called nodes, and the places where there is constructive interference are called antinodes. Antinodes are where the standing wave amplitude is biggest, and nodes show where the wave amplitude is zero. So a standing wave is a wave that has nodes, which are points that don't move at all and result from destructive interference, and antinodes where the wave amplitude is biggest thanks to constructive interference. Even though these waves are called standing, they still have a speed. It's equal to their frequency times their wavelength. In general, standing sound waves can exist in three types of systems. One, with both ends closed, like a tube with both ends capped. A system with one end closed and the other opened, called a closed-ended tube. One with both ends open, like a flute. The type of system affects what kinds of waves can form inside the tube. For any standing wave system, there is a wave frequency called the fundamental frequency. It is the lowest possible frequency of a wave. This limit has to do with the shape of the wave's boundary. And if you double or triple or quadruple the fundamental frequency, you have what are called harmonics, multiples of the fundamental. Harmonics follow a mathematical pattern we can write out as an equation. Let's look at three types of standing wave systems and learn about the fundamental frequency and harmonics for each one. In a tube with both ends closed, standing waves must begin and end at the center of the end caps. Only nodes can form at these places. The most basic shape of a wave that can fit in this space, with the node at each end, looks like this, and this wave corresponds to the fundamental frequency. The harmonics of this wave, the allowed multiples of the fundamental frequency, follow the equation L, the length of the tube, equals N divided by 2 times lambda, the wavelength, where N is any positive integer, 1, 2, 3, etc. The second type of standing wave system has one end open and the other one closed. In a system like this, a node will form at the closed end and an antinode will form at the open end. The fundamental frequency corresponds to a wavelength that looks like this. In this case, the harmonics of the fundamental frequency follow the equation L equals M divided by 4 times lambda, where M is any odd positive integer, 1, 3, 5, etc. And for the third type, where both ends are open, the standing waves begin and end at the edge of the tube. Antinodes will form at each end because the ends are open. The fundamental frequency corresponds to a wavelength that looks like this. The harmonics for a system like this follow the same equation as for the tube closed at both ends. The tube length L equals N divided by 2 times lambda, where N is any positive integer. Let's look at an example of a standing wave system where both ends are closed. You decide to make an instrument closed at both ends, capable of playing 4 notes with 4 different pipes, one at 20 Hz, one at 40 Hz, one at 80 Hz, and a note at 120 Hz. The speed of sound in air is 343 meters per second. How long do the 4 pipes in the instrument need to play these notes? In other words, what are L1, L2, L3, and L4? And what are the wavelengths of these notes? Lambda 1, lambda 2, lambda 3, and lambda 4. The first thing we can do is figure out what the wavelengths of these notes will be. The sound in the pipes travels in air, which means its speed is about 343 meters per second. We've seen that the speed of a wave equals its frequency times its wavelength. That means we can solve for wavelength by dividing wave speed by wave frequency. The wavelength for our lowest frequency equals 343 meters per second divided by 20 Hz, which equals 17.2 meters. The wavelength of the 40 Hz wave is 343 meters per second divided by 40 Hz, which equals 8.6 meters. Same thing with the higher frequencies. Lambda 3 equals 343 meters per second divided by 80 Hz, which equals 4.3 meters. And lambda 4 equals 343 meters per second divided by 120 Hz, which equals 2.9 meters. These wavelengths tell us something about how long our pipes will need to be. Since we have a pipe with both ends closed, we know our fundamental wavelength would have one node at the center of each end of the pipe. This means one half of a fundamental wavelength can fit in the pipe. Since we've already figured out the fundamental wavelengths of the four frequencies our instrument is made for, we can divide those wavelengths in half to solve for the lengths of the pipe we'll need. L1, the length of the longest pipe, that has our wavelength of 17.2 meters, is 17.2 meters divided by 2, which is 8.6 meters. That's how long the longest pipe needs to be to make a note at 20 hertz. L2, our second longest pipe, equals lambda 2, which is 8.6 meters divided by 2. That's 4.3 meters. That's the second longest pipe length. L3 is lambda 3 divided by 2, or 4.3 meters divided by 2, which equals 2.2 meters. And finally, L4 equals lambda 4 divided by 2, which is 2.9 meters divided by 2, which equals 1.4 meters. Here's another example. You decide to make standing sound waves in a 1 meter long pipe, with one end open and the other end closed. What is the fundamental wavelength of your instrument? To start answering these questions, it will be helpful to draw a picture of our instrument and the fundamental wavelength that can exist inside. The pipe has one open and one closed end. That means our fundamental wavelength will connect at the edge of the open end of the pipe, where there will be an antinode and it will have just one node at the closed end. A general rule for pipes like this is their fundamental wavelength is 4 times the length of the pipe. We can see that 1/4 wavelength fits inside the 1 meter pipe. That means our instrument's fundamental wavelength is 4.0 meters. Could we hear a note like this? Let's check what frequency a 4 meter sound wave has. Wave speed equals wavelength multiplied by wave frequency. The speed of sound in air is about 343 meters per second. Our wavelength is 4.0 meters. We can rearrange our equation so that frequency equals speed divided by wavelength. 343 meters per second divided by 4.0 meters equals 86 hertz. This note is towards the lower end of our hearing range, but we can hear it. It would sound something like the hum of an industrial-sized air conditioning equipment. Now, for an example of a standing wave in a pipe with both ends open, the speed of sound in air is about 343 meters per second. Find the fundamental frequency, the first harmonic, of an open-ended tube with a length of 81.3 centimeters. When we make a drawing of the wavelength corresponding to the fundamental frequency in an open-ended tube, we see that it includes half a wavelength, with antinodes on each end of the pipe. That means a full wavelength is 2 times the length of the tube, 81.3 centimeters. 2 times 81.3 centimeters is 162.6 centimeters, or 1.63 meters. That's one full wavelength at the fundamental frequency. We can use the wave speed equation, V equals wavelength times frequency, to solve for the fundamental frequency. F equals wave speed divided by wavelength. Our wave speed is the speed of sound in air, 343 meters per second. Wavelength is 1.63 meters. 343 meters per second divided by 1.63 meters is 210 hertz. That is the fundamental frequency of this standing wave system. There's often more than one way to find the answer to a standing wave question. As we finish up, keep in mind two really important points. Remember that the speed of a wave equals its frequency times its wavelength. Second, be aware of the differences between a wave system, like a string or a pipe, that has two closed ends, one fixed and one open end, and two open ends. Each of these three conditions are treated differently. If you understand each one, you will know how to begin solving any standing wave question. That's a closer look on standing waves. For more physics in motion, go to our homepage, where the entire series is available to you.